You're listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network, now the largest new media platform on the web, and your number one source for after-show entertainment. Very good, Gene Johnson. The AfterBuzz Studios in Los Angeles, California. Presented by Maria Menounos and Bing.com. And streaming live thanks to Akamai Technologies. This is AfterBuzz TV's Dancing with the Stars After Show. We'll break down tonight's episode and get you all the latest news and gossip. And now, another post-game wrap-up show for your favorite TV show. It's AfterBuzz TV's Dancing with the Stars After Show.
We are here. Woo! Bing is for doing, and we're here doing another season of Dancing with the Stars. It is season 17, episode 1. I'm Kristen Burt, and we are so excited to be back because this is a rejuvenated, pretty exciting season we have ahead of us. All right, you'll notice not everybody is here, but I will let you know. I know. I will let you know that Suri Serrano is on the phone joining us from Chicago. She'll be back in studio next week and Anna Trebunskaya and baby Trebunskaya will hopefully be joining us next week as well. So let me introduce who is in studio, and that is across from me, my co-host, Jake Dupree.
Hi, everybody. I'm so excited about this season. It's amazing.
That's kind of how I feel. I'm like, it's Christmas. And sitting right next to Jake is our very esteemed guest, season 16 troop member, Jules Tucker. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me. Thank you. It's great to be here.
We have so many good topics to talk about, and we've only got 1 hour. Let's say hello to Suri. Suri.
Hi, everybody. About the season starting finally, and can't wait to be back in studio with you next week.
Very good. All right, now let's kick it off. I was like, I forgot about Suri. She's up here floating in the air. All right, I think I want to just start off because we are down to one day a week. Yeah. But I think it brought some new energy. How did you guys feel?
I thought that I thought it was really nice. I like how the judges' scores come right after that. That's so nice to avoid all the small talk. I think that's amazing.
I have to say, avoiding the awkward Brooke Burke talk. And I don't mean to be mean for her, but I think sometimes they're asking her to stretch or something, and she ran out of a question, and then you're just like, okay, here we go. And I think it just keeping it going. Tom Bergeron's the best ringmaster out there.
Definitely. The pace of it was much better, I think. We saw more dancing. Like, you saw more dancing going on, less, like, chit-chat, and it was, you know, definitely much better paced show, I think.
Totally agree. What did you think, Suri?
I liked it. I really liked the new format, you guys. I mean, I'm glad to hear that you all liked it as well. I think I liked a lot of the changes, to be honest. I know we haven't gone there yet, but, yeah, I think it's a positive. Well done.
Yeah, and we have a new set on top of all this. Now, I'm not sure that all of the new set works just yet, but, you know, I've talked a lot about this, that Sue, You Think You Can Dance took a whole season to get its new rhythm when they lost their result show. It's going to take some time. We have to be a little patient, but we have now moved the celebrities from the Skybox, or the Celebriquarium, down to the judges. I'm a little bit, like, thrown off that they're on the other side of the stage, but it is the sexy bus stop, according to Tom Bergeron.
Bus stop. I think that's really weird that they sit there. I don't know. It just doesn't work for me. I think it's uncomfortable to be, like, performing and then to see them there, but it also might enhance the competition. I don't know.
I mean, you had some good points on this, Jules.
I mean, from the set, like, I was sitting there watching it last night, it didn't look so bad. I thought it was actually kind of cool because you saw the judges and you saw all the celebs and all the pros right next door to them. So you could kind of, you know, you could see what was going on. Because when they're upstairs, it's like their private little box. You know, you don't know what's going on. And then you notice, like, you know, if they were messing about or they were getting up
tweeting.
To, you know?
I saw a lot of tweeting, them tweeting and taking photos.
Yeah, they were getting caught a lot on the Twitter and everything like that. So, I didn't mind it. I think they're trialing stuff, so, you know, we've got to see how it works. And I know we had problems with traffic because getting people caught in the background and things going on. I know this was an issue, but it's the first show. And to be honest, production did such a great job with the first show.
They did. It's live, really, and you have to keep on moving. Yeah. Sir, what did you think of the sexy bus stop?
The judges being on the other side doesn't throw me off. I think I'm wondering, I want to talk to some of the cast members. I caught Tony texting. I don't know if you guys saw that, but you know, they're used to being able to hide up there in this love aquarium and kind of do their thing. So I wonder if some of the pros kind of Hem and Hod about moving down there. And, you know, you have to be more on, I think.
Yeah, definitely.
I don't know.
And you talked a little and Jules talked a little bit about the celebs not having time to prep with their contestant. They just had to be like, okay, go out on the floor.
I know.
No warm up.
There's no, like, there's not as much preparation time. Whereas before, when up in the box, you'd go down a lot earlier before your dance and you could be out the back, you know, warming up, just check in. You're going through some bits, calming your celeb down because the nerves are going crazy at that point. And now it's like, boom, you're on, boom, one, two, three, here we go. It was quite as much faster. So you've got to be way more prepared, I think, and for all the pros this season. Preparation is going to be.
It makes me so nervous too that they ask them questions right before they.
Yeah,
come.
I know.
Like, please just let them have.
I'm like,
their
get me in my zone. I'm
yeah.
like,
I thought Leah Remini might throw up.
I know.
She looked nervous. Go ahead, sorry.
Hey, Kristen. You know what I wanted to say too. I do love all that, like the opening number, how they utilized the front and they had the fans out there in the walkway, and I really liked how they have the makeup and hair setups and stations. I just like some of the changes. It makes I have a fresh feeling now watching the show.
Yeah, it's a little bit more open, and you kind of get it's sort of like they pulled like the screen back, and you're like, this is what it really looks like behind the scenes, which is nice, and it looks like they're gonna have the audience out there this season, from what it sounded like. But let's get into the dances and talk very quickly about that opening number that was done by Mandy Moore.
Yes.
Another So You Think You Can Dance reference. But and very similar to what we saw from Nappy Tabs
in
So You Think You Can Dance this season, which is that whole one shot.
Mm-hmm.
But I still love it. I don't care.
Yeah, I thought and it was a cool way to introduce all the celebrities too, to, you know, like randomly bring them like in. That was really cool. I don't know. I liked it.
Now did you miss being in studio? Did you miss the big staircase where all the celebs get introduced and walk down and have their grand entrance? Because I did hear a lot of people saying they missed that.
I like that. I like that entrance. I love the staircase. So I like into the big ballroom. I thought I do like
that.
Yeah, but nice. This is different again. So it was really cool the way they did the opening number for this week. I know next week it's going to be again different.
Yeah.
But I did like that staircase, the walk down. I thought that's pretty cool.
Very old school.
yeah, it is. But it's like typical ballroom. So like, you know, come down into the ballroom. It was cool.
All right, we've got 12 dances. Let's get into it.
Because,
oh my goodness, we have so many. We kick off the night with Brant Daugherty and PETA doing the cha-cha. I think that they're probably the best-looking couple of the season.
Holy cow,
genetic lottery. I thought this was great out of the gate. It's really hard to be the first person of a new season with so many changes.
Yeah.
He's young. He's a good performer. Better than I thought he was going to be. I'm not sure by the end of the night, though, I still remembered him.
Exactly. Seeing that package before, I was like, oh, Lord Jesus, because it was a little awkward and stiff. And I was like, just like go with it. And he did. I thought that he improved a lot just from the package, like from his rehearsals.
Yeah.
And I mean, to be partnered with PETA, I mean, that's like my dream, basically. But so the two of them, I like live vicariously through him. But I'm so excited for this couple. I think that they're really going to be around for a while. And he has so many fans as Noel Kahn from Pretty Little Liars. Not that I'm a fan or anything of Pretty Little Liars, but I am. I'll admit it. But yeah, I'm really excited for them. I think that they're going to be an awesome, awesome force to be reckoned with. So,
what'd you see in studio, Jules?
I always think for the female pros, it's always a much harder job than the guys, because if you're a male pro, you know, you're leading, you're timing, you've got more to do, and as a celebrity trying to learn that stuff is always really hard. And I actually thought he did a real good job. For the first week, first up, cha-cha, he had a lot of proper cha-cha content in there as well. I thought PETA's choreo this week was absolutely fantastic. And as a cha-cha number, I thought it was really, really good. And I was surprised, pleasantly surprised by him, actually. I thought it was going to be a little bit more wooden, and it's not an easy first week to do. It's cha-cha and the action and the technique and the posture and everything, it's a mission. And I thought he did really well. I'm excited to see they've got Rumba next week, I believe.
I can't wait for that. I have it written down.
So I'm excited.
Yeah, he's got Rumba.
Yeah, to see how it is.
That'll be amazing.
Yeah, sorry, what did you think about Brant and PETA?
I agree with you, Kristen. I think that they were, you know, for me it was good. I agree with everything you all have said, actually, about this couple. But, you know, they weren't the most memorable for me, sure.
Yeah.
It built up from there. It just keep building up and up and up. It was like a massive show.
Mm-hmm.
And every time someone came out, you're just like, whoa, are you serious? Again and again and again.
And this is so interesting because this is a season with a lot of stories. And we were talking about why didn't the All-Star season work when everyone can dance? And we have a lot of people that can dance in this season, but we already knew their stories.
Exactly.
It's fun to have the discovery of what their journey is. So Brant has got the Pretty Little Liar fan base. He's all
His
set.
Twitter following is like unbelievable.
Ridiculous. 22787, I thought it was a good way to start.
Yeah.
A lot of people were upset about inflated scores, but there's been a little bit of chatter. It seems the way they're doing eliminations, they count the America's vote from this current week,
yep.
and then they count the judges' score from the next week. So it almost makes this week's judges' score kind of null and void.
Yeah.
So maybe that's why we had inflated scores. Yeah. That's what I was thinking.
I got a bit excited.
Next, we go to Leah Remini and Tony doing the foxtrot. Okay, Leah, she's so interesting because she's really sassy and she speaks her mind. I've interviewed her a few times, but it's also interesting to see the quiet side of her, the one that needs to build her self-confidence.
Yeah, she pulled back a bit in that performance, I thought.
I think so, too.
And then it's the nerves. Mm-hmm. It's you don't want to mess it up. And you've been working so hard.
And she had J-Lo sitting right there on her side. I was like, what?
Bam! They're friends.
Yeah.
They're really good friends.
But that's scary because she's an amazing dancer. And to be like, oh, my God. Like, the first week out, like, come 3 weeks. Like, let's go week three. Like, bring J-Lo then. I don't know.
But she had a nice elegance to her. I mean, did you see that, Suri?
I was excited to see this performance. I talked to Tony before they performed, and he said that she's quite a slave driver. He is, like, they are working very long hours together because she just doesn't want to stop rehearsing, which I just think is awesome.
Yeah, that's cool.
And, I thought she looked gorgeous, and I was pleasantly surprised. I didn't really know what to expect, and I think she'll continue to improve.
I think she will. Now, are they working beyond the regulated 4 hours that they're only allowed a day?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Don't bust them if they are. We'll keep that under wraps.
No,
everyone can read between the lines on that. 21 was their score, 777 across the board.
Yeah.
Decent.
Fair
I mean,
enough.
Yeah, I think it's totally fair and gives her a nice room to improve.
She's going to really improve in this competition, I think.
I think so, too.
After that first week, that's done. And then it's like the adrenaline and everything with the rush. And then, like, today I've spoken to a few of them, like, oh, thank God that first week's done.
For
now
everyone.
We can go. It's like,
it's been interesting talking to a couple of the pros, too. They're like, we just need to get even this new schedule under our belt and just feel it out. Because you know what to expect in seasons past, but not anymore. It's a new season.
Yeah.
Okay, then we go to Corbin and Karina doing contemporary. And okay, I got to say something. Should, and I'm going to throw this out, you guys can put it in the YouTube comments, should contemporary be out there in the first week? Because I understand that it's Dancing with the Stars, it's not ballroom Dancing with the Stars, but I feel like contemporary, and one of the Twitter followers brought this up, contemporary has no rules, per se. I mean, you might want to throw in some lifts and stuff like that. But, you know, foxtrot, cha-cha, those are clearly ballroom dances with rules.
Traditional.
Mm-hmm. Can you judge these properly one against the other? Because it is kind of jarring to go from, like, foxtrot and cha-cha to contemporary.
I think it's smart to just come out the gate with all ballroom because that's what the show has been based on. So I think it's nice to be like, oh, this is the... let's see where they improve. Because contemporary, they can free flow and, you know... There's a little bit ways to mask technique in contemporary, I think, instead of ballroom. So I'd wish that he would have gotten something, you know, really ballroom.
Yeah, I wish they would just wait and do contemporary later in the season.
Same
How do you feel?
Yeah, I'm like mixed on this topic as well because I feel like it should be more traditional ballroom and Latin dances because it's Dancing with the Stars, not So You Think You Can Dance with the Stars.
Right.
So, you know, a little bit like this, I feel. But you know what? It's actually kind of fresh and nice to see it.
Mm-hmm.
So, and I really... really enjoyed Karina's number.
Mm-hmm.
It was fantastic.
They're another good-looking couple. What am I saying?
They
just
package.
Peter and Brandt.
I know.
But they've been at the top of my list before the season even started.
Yeah.
Corbin is someone that has...
We all expect a lot of
him. Yeah, definitely. Everyone's watching him for sure to see how he's going to do. So.
The only thing I thought with the choreography, I thought it was a little too frantic. I wanted them to, like, and it could have been nerves, too, that they could have been, like, a beat ahead, but I wanted to just, like, take a breath and relax. Sorry, we've been talking a lot about, you know, contemporary and the choreography, but what did you think out of the gate?
You know, excellent point, Kristen, bringing up about the contemporary. It's awesome to have it during the season at some point, but week one, not so much of a fan of it.
Yeah, I think week one's a bit early, to be honest.
Yeah, I think
but their number was great. I did enjoy them. Definitely enjoyed it. Just maybe not week one.
Yeah. I think Tristan had week one last season, too, if I'm correct.
Oh, yes.
With Dorothy, who was fantastic.
Yeah, that was beautiful.
then we lost her.
I think Kelly Pickler had Jazz or something first week last year, too.
Yeah, I think so.
Or, and What did Zendaya have the week out, the first week?
It was contemporary.
It was contemporary. Uh-huh. That's what I thought, too. Yeah. So he got a 24. These are going to be two contenders to watch. Karina must have been thrilled when she found out her partner was Corbin. And
he's doing the jive next week, correct?
Yeah. Jive next week.
He is going to be so sharp and so clean with that. I'm so excited.
I just
excited.
Heard today as well from one of the pros, like, you should see Karina's jive. It's just ridiculous.
Yes, so, I can't wait.
Guys, it's going to be insane, I'm sure.
That's amazing.
Oh, that is a good thing.
I can't wait.
Yeah, yeah, they're a hot couple, and I'll tell you, they're going to be there in the end. That's all I can say.
They will,
I mean, there's nothing else to say about that.
Definitely.
And here's a nice surprise. We come to Jack Osborne and Cheryl Burke doing the Foxtrot.
Yeah.
Another person with a big story. I mean, not only does he have an MS diagnosis, but he and his wife just lost their baby. She was in the second trimester. Can the guy get a break? But he came out there with such joy. His wife looked so happy in the audience, and I thought Cheryl did an awesome job with him.
Oh, my word. I was so impressed by him. I was not expecting that at all. He was super light on his feet, and I liked in the package that she was saying that he really learned the steps quickly. I was not expecting that at all. And I liked that she covered that entire floor with the choreography. I noticed with some of the pieces, they were all kind of contained in one area, and I was like, move, people, move. And I thought that I thought they both were fantastic.
Yeah, again, absolutely surprised too with that. I couldn't believe he walked out. And Cheryl, I thought she looked amazing too. And they really, the whole package of that dance was amazing. And he looked pretty good and confident. And he's like, he got into it more towards the end.
Yes.
He started really getting into it a bit more, which is normal. And it's week one, guys. I mean, come on.
That's
and it was
so
still
good.
Really good.
Yeah, and he's got that musicality. Remember, he has a foundation of it from his family. And Cheryl did. Her hair looked good. She looks good. I don't know what she was doing over the summer, but she looks happy. And you had Ozzy and Sharon in the audience, too. We had lots of stars in the audience.
That was really nice.
That was kind of awesome. I mean,
that was so sweet to see her cry, too, over him. That was really cute.
That Osborne family has gone through a lot of medical crises. I don't know what it is in that family, but
I've seen a lot of stuff in that family.
They have seen a lot of stuff. So I'm happy that I think they love the show, too, because it was such a nice thing for Kelly. Mm-hmm. It was a nice journey for her. So they probably think of it very fondly.
Yeah.
Suri, what did you think about Jack?
I got to say he was my favorite surprise cast member of the season. I was so excited to see him in there. And then to watch him, I feel like I'm watching my younger brother. I just have nothing but love for him. And I know Anna Trubinskaya wrote up in an article that he might be her new crush of the season. And he might be mine, too. I really was I loved watching them. I just love him.
I do, too. There was something about it. It just made me smile.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I saw on Twitter that Lisa Vanderpump said that was her favorite contestant, too, this year. Yeah.
See, he's gonna. He might be the dark horse.
I think so,
too.
I thought it was going to be Bill Nye, because he is a swing dancer, and it's not going to be him. I'm sorry. I love Bill Nye the Science Guy, but it's not going to be him. Okay. We've got a lot to talk about with this one, because, you know, when you bring out Derek, there's always going to be controversy.
Uh-huh.
You know, and I think a lot of people thought, well, he had Kelly Pickler, and he had, like, his choice, you know, amazing dancer. And then you think Amber Riley's going to be okay.
Yeah.
And then she comes out and bam!
Oh, my God.
Throws it down on the table, on that dance floor. You know what I loved about this? What we get to see a little bit more this year, you know, because it's the way they bring him up off the floor. She got into her position, and then, you know, she was like this. She checked her toe point and checked her position. And I was like, damn.
She's ready, bro.
She knows.
She was so switched on last night.
She was ready for her cha-cha. So, go. Jules, what do you think?
Again, this was a huge surprise. I mean, especially for a girl that size, too, to move and do all those, to do everything like that. I've got to take my hat off. It was really good. It was really good. It was fun. It was energetic. I really liked that song as well they used. We used it last season, actually, in the troop for a troop number. But it had great energy. And, I mean, she killed it. She really, everyone's did a really good job.
Yeah. It was.
I feel like I'm repeating myself a bit. But really,
but for week
night,
one, what the heck is going on? Like, what's in the water?
I don't know what they're taking, but I might need some, too.
I was so nervous because I saw her on Ellen, and she was like, well, I've never really danced. I mean, I do some stuff in Glee, like step touch stuff, but that's about it. But this, I did not expect that at all. And she slayed this dance. And she came out and she turned the entire crowd around, because I feel like after there was like a few, it was like kind of not sleepy moments, but it was still a little bit, it was getting a buildup. And this was just like that wow moment of the night. And I couldn't believe this was week one. Week one for a dance. That's crazy.
That is crazy.
And in the package, I think she was trying to say, like, you know, I don't dance, I sing or whatever. And then, so we were all kind of expecting, oh, God, yeah, this isn't going to be. Yeah.
Step touch.
We'll see what happens.
Touch.
Yeah.
Nailed it.
All right, let's talk about Derek and Amber, sorry.
Yeah, oh, I'm right there with you guys. And wow, that was so much fun. And I didn't really know what to expect. I knew as a performer that she was going to do really well, but I had no idea what level. You know, when you have talk about Derek Huff's partners, they're always at a pretty high level, I think. I have a little bit of inside info for you.
Scoop it.
I've been told that in the past that Max has asked to have Derek's partner because they always tend to be pretty good.
Ooh. They do, and you're going to stir up so much controversy now in the YouTube comments. And let's talk a little. Let's just talk quickly. Derek is probably one of the finest choreographers of his generation.
Oh, yeah.
He's got two Emmy nominations coming up this weekend, one by himself and one with Allison Hawker. You know, he does get some of the better contestants, and yes, the producers put him together with better contestants because they want him to stay around as long as possible in the show, and it's good TV, and I don't know what else to say, because if you don't like Derek, and if you're in the Max and Val category, know that Val is getting good contestants too.
Really great contestants.
And he's a great teacher. I think Derek, his strength is the choreography, and I think Val is a really interesting teacher. He takes, like, the way he took Kelly Monaco two seasons ago and made her a dancer.
Yeah.
Amazing. So they each have different strengths, and we have to look to that and see in the end what winds up winning. And I know if Derek wins this season, people are going to freak out.
I know.
I mean, what do you think, Suri?
I don't know. You know, I mean, Derek is such a talent. And yes, everybody on the show is talented, but you know, I didn't know what to expect. Like I said with Amber, when I knew that they were paired up, I was like, oh, maybe he didn't get one of the best people, but she's amazing. So I'm really excited to watch them this season.
I am too.
I think she'll make it to the finals too, or like really close to them.
Well, and then you've got the Glee fans too. So
I mean,
that's another one. Pretty Little Liars, Glee. You're looking at some strong numbers there. I just want to go back and remind everyone, Jack's score was 23. I don't think I mentioned it. Amber and Derek got the highest score of the night with their cha-cha at 27. And you know,
big scores this week.
Very. It's going to be tough.
I was interested to understand why they're so high for the first week. I mean, it doesn't leave so much room for later on. But I don't know. You know, it's what they think.
I think Nicole Scherzinger, didn't she get all nines on her first week, too? Oh,
yeah. And she had a high level.
She's a dance. Yeah.
I know. That was another one that people freaked out about. I mean, that's the thing. If these scores don't count towards next week's elimination, I mean, Amber, let's be honest, Amber's not getting eliminated. But I guess it's just like, here's your 27. Now let's throw it out.
Do you know what she's doing next week?
I do, I believe. Let me see. Do I have Amber's? I don't have all of them yet, so I don't have theirs yet.
Okay. I'd be interested to see what she's going to do.
I pulled as many from Twitter as I could find. It's a mystery, though. And did anyone see, by the way, Derek's ripped jacket at the end? Their cha-cha was so hot, the seams, the split were just kind of awesome. I cha-cha'd my jacket off. Elizabeth and Val are next doing contemporary, and this was someone I was really interested in seeing because...
Me too.
I mean, come on, we've all seen Showgirls. Let's be honest.
Yeah.
Don't
hide
it. You've all seen it more than once. Okay?
I think I stole
just
the
tune
video
on VH1 every weekend.
It's on all the time. Some of you may watch it for the nudity if you watch the unedited version.
Oh, no, purely the dancing.
Purely the dancing. Just
the
like
technique.
You read Playboy for the articles. So, but, you know, I wasn't surprised that Showgirls killed her dance spirit figures. But, you know, it's one of those things that in movies like that, the actress or the actor oftentimes gets blamed instead of the writer, the producers, the director.
Yeah, it's not fair, really.
It's not really fair. But I'm so glad she's back, and I think that they're going to be a gorgeous couple.
They are, and she's going to improve so much throughout the season. Like, I thought this one, I was expecting a little bit more just from Showgirls days, but I mean, some of her, like her foot, like her feet were beautiful, and some of the lifts were really nice, and her legs were great. So I mean, I'm anxious to see what she's gonna bring. I didn't think this was, this wasn't my favorite for her, but that's just because I expect a lot from her. So
I do too.
It's week one as well, and I know like with the pros, you know, they don't want to throw everything out there the first week. That they want to save a little bit maybe too. And I know Val is like an extremely, extremely good teacher, like you said, and I know he's got for sure some stuff up his sleeve for later on. She looks like she can do anything. Her position, her posture, and her technique look pretty phenomenal. And I really enjoyed that number. I thought it was really pure. She really meant like what she was doing, and she wanted to be good, you know? Mm-hmm. I really enjoyed that. I felt like she kind of could connect a little bit with her there. I thought it was good, even though the judges didn't agree, I don't think, with that, but whatever.
I'm like, again, I know they're like, eh. But, you know, like, hey, she's out there, so this is, she probably feels very vulnerable being back and dance.
And she just had a baby, too. Yeah.
I think she had a good package again, too, like, You were thinking about, oh, God, what's going to happen? And, you know, because of the movie, she said, and, you know, she never really connected back with dance. This was her first one. So it was like, I wanted it to be good for her.
Everyone's downloading Showgirls again this weekend. Sir, what did you think of Elizabeth and Val? You know it. Come on.
Well, first thing I wanted to say is I met Elizabeth a few years ago, and I just want to say that she's one of the sweetest and kindest people I've met in Hollywood.
Oh, cool.
And Val and I just... These two, I'm really excited to watch. I think that we are going to be in, we're in store for some special dances with these two.
Yeah.
I agree. I think that they're going to, Val is always good with the emotional connection. He's always good at putting together the technique with the emotional connection with his dancers. And I think that he's going to be able to do a little bit more. Zendaya was younger, so sometimes when they did some of the sexier dances, it was
like brother and sister, a little bit awkward. Yeah.
He's going to be able to do what he couldn't do with Zendaya last season, which I think will be really nice. And they got a 24. Room to grow.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, before we go on to the other six dances, we just want to remind everyone that you can download us on iTunes and rate us 5 stars, of course. But remember, it's a new season. We love to hear from you and let us know who you want to see. This was a request. Jules was a request, and we got him here in studio. So continue to let us know who you would like to see on our show this season. And we are working behind the scenes so hard to get everyone that we possibly can. Know that the schedule is hard. Yeah. How hard is that Dancing with the Stars rehearsal schedule?
Every day it chips and changes, like you have no idea. It's crazy. So I'm sure if they can, though, they'll try their best, you know?
Yes, and it happens that we get someone and then they get voted off and they go to New York, and so we have to scramble and get someone else. It's just the way it goes, but we sure appreciate it. And one other thing, we want to remind you that Serial Buddies is out on DVD today. So Jake, why don't you tell us about it?
Yes, you can go and buy it on iTunes, on Amazon, you can stream it live on Google, I do believe, and it's a really great movie. It keeps our lights on here. We don't really have very many advertisements within our program, so this is our chance to be like, you should support us a little bit. So there you go. If you want to buy it, and it's available in other stores too. So it's a great movie. Really, really funny.
Thanks, Jake.
You're welcome.
You're adorable. All right. So we go next to... And I think we have a lot to talk about with this couple. Bill Nye, the science guy.
Yeah.
And Tyne Steckline, who is new. Everyone rhymes, huh? Bill Nye, the science guy. Tyne
Steckline.
Doing the cha-cha. And this is so interesting because I have to say that I was a little bit disappointed. I think in my head I had built them up more because he is a social dancer. He does some swing dancing.
So you can see that. You can see that in the package before.
That was great.
He's good. I think that this pairing is wrong. And I've got to be honest. He's a little socially awkward, which I think is really adorable and cute. Mm-hmm. But I feel like she looks so young. She looks so young.
Yeah.
I know she looks way younger than her age. And he's a little bit older, and I'm not sure if it was the right pairing for the two of them. She's beautiful and adorable, you know, and he's dorky and cute. But I'm not sure it like blends well together.
She just doesn't, for me, she just lacks the finesse that someone who has been a part of the show for a while possesses. And I think that was the part that lacked for me. I was like, there was no... I don't think it was necessarily his fault that he didn't have the proper teaching or the proper choreography. I mean, I think she's beautiful, and her lines are gorgeous, and if you go back and watch that Curly performance with her and Jeremy Hudson, like, she's amazing, and she can really, really dance.
Yeah.
I just don't think this was the right time for her to be on the show. She's beautiful, but I don't know. It's just not the right time.
You know, and there's one thing, let's just talk about it since it's out here before we get deep into their cha-cha. I mean, can you tell about the benefits of being in the troupe? Because I think that the experience, the exposure, the choreography you guys get to do, it's tremendous.
Yeah, I mean, stepping into the troupe first before going moving up, I think it helps a lot, because also not just with choreography and all that preparation, but you also see how the production, how it works. And you see also the from week one to week 10, you see how all the pros are dealing with all their celebrities mentally and physically. There's a lot going on. And so also there's those points that people don't actually understand, like the fans and stuff of the show don't get the mental side of it is half, more. I'll say it's more, really. And so for her first time being a pro, it's going to be a lot harder for her without having, I think, that full-time troupe experience. But at the same time, she is a phenomenal dancer.
Michael Jackson.
Holy. Like,
if you're good enough for Michael Jackson.
If you're good enough for MJ, you're good enough, really.
You're amazing. Come on.
And, you know, and I think she's got, she looks fantastic on camera. I mean, she,
unbelievable.
Camera loves her. She's beautiful. Hot,
so she works it well, really. And maybe they needed her for him to bring him up because, you know, Bill Nye, I mean, I don't know the guy, but, you know, you all seem to do.
In New Zealand,
we didn't have science.
We didn't have Bill Nye the science guy.
Dude, man. Yeah, he's quite popular.
What do you think about this pairing, Suri?
You made an interesting point. I hadn't actually thought of that. And I'm thinking now while you all were talking that maybe somebody like a Cheryl would have been better for him, you know?
I had said Sharna.
Yeah.
Kim Johnson, who's in Australia this season. Mm-hmm. But, and maybe that's it. Maybe you just needed someone with, Tyne seems very, very sweet. Maybe you need someone that's a little bit more.
You're going to do this, yeah.
Strong, yeah. In that direction. I mean, we'll see where it goes, because next week they've got the Paso Doble.
Right. It'll be kind of like Andy doing like the Zorro Paso Doble.
Yeah.
Like, it'll be cute. He's the heart of the show. Like Carrie Ann said, he is the heart. Like, this is what the show's about.
So. I think we said that, like, he might be the Andy Dick of the season.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, completely.
He's not going anywhere next week. Yeah. I don't think he's getting eliminated.
And I don't necessarily want him to go anywhere. I think he's really fun to watch. I don't think he'll last for a long time, but he's really cute and silly and sweet.
He's adorable. And, you know, I have to say that the judges were really harsh on them, and I felt
I thought it was a bit much.
It was a bit much. And what was it, like 5-4-5? Come
That's
on.
Ridiculous.
You could have given, like, 5 straight across the board or thrown in a 6 in there.
Exactly. I thought that was a bit hard. I mean, come on.
You know, the one thing I think it was Len that said there was not enough cha-cha content, and I think that's why I gave him the 4.
I hate when that. Sorry.
He was.
I hate when they say that about cha-cha content. I mean, there needs to be this rule book and Carrie Ann's lift policy.
Oh,
I mean, there needs to be an actual book to say how many bars of choreography can there be? Because I see it all the time that the choreos is not much cha-cha or waltz or foxtrot or whatever, and it's mixing and changing, but they don't say that about somebody else. It's like they pick the one that they want. I don't know. It's annoying.
Strange.
It's annoying.
Sorry, you sound like you're chomping at the bit. We can hear you.
Oh, yeah, you can hear me. Sorry. I'm chomping at the bit. I totally agree that it was just, I did not appreciate the judges coming at him so harshly. It was a little too much for my taste. That was really one of the main notes I had from the entire show, because it is Bill. He was so sweet, and I was rooting for him, and no, was it the best routine or even in the middle of the road? No, but they just, after people have worked for weeks, you know, worked so hard to come at him so harshly in that first moment, right when you finish, it didn't sit well with my heart.
You could tell he felt really down, too, especially even at the end of the show when they were like, Amber's on the top and Bill Nye's is on the bottom. He just looked really defeated, kind of. So.
I felt defeated for him, and I don't know him. And it's just, and that's what I felt like for both of them. I mean, you make your big pro debut, and then it's just like, stab, stab, boom, stab, stab. And you're like, what the heck, man?
Yeah.
I mean, you have to, and then you have to get back and go into the studio and start all over again. And
it could be like cold water in your face, kind of like, wake it up a little bit.
Yeah, maybe it was a good show. I don't think he's going anywhere next week. I really think
the whole studio was chanting his name after they finished, like a whole entire place. I was like, this is amazing. The energy was awesome. The energy was amazing. Everyone was chanting. It was cool.
And you know, we've been talking about cha-cha content, but I think like this season, I would love for all of us to talk a lot about choreography and stuff. We did a lot of it, you and I, with So You Think You Can Dance, because I think that the choreography is just as important to what the pros and the celebs are doing out in the dance floor.
They have to show these people off.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, and the pros have to be accountable for what they're doing week to week. So
that's true.
We'll talk a lot about that this season, but I wish there was a rule book. Like, this is what we're looking for in the cha-cha, and this is what we're looking for in Foxtrot, because it would help. We move right along to Keyshawn Johnson and Sharna. I gotta say, for a football player, I thought there'd be a lot of more natural movement, and I was a little bit like, uh-oh, because usually the football players make it close to the end in the top five.
Pretty, yeah.
Athletes do. I'm not sure he's gonna make it.
I don't think so either. I was just underwhelmed. I thought he would really bring it and be that showman, because they always come out and they're always like on fire, and he looked like some of the packages where he was like running the touchdowns and he was like you know, like celebrating, but this, it just was kind of like a lumbering person.
He's big. How big is he, Jules?
He is, what is he, 6'5"?
Crazy.
He is a unit. He is a G-unit. So, you know, it's that can't be easy to move that body like that.
Charna's petite.
And she's small.
Tiny.
Yeah.
Tiny. But, I mean, are we just used to seeing Jacoby, like, last season, like, the showman out there? Were we expecting another Jacoby?
And Donald Driver and people like that. That's what I was expecting, too.
I was expecting Jacoby
but getting nerves, guys. Yeah. The first week, again, it's like, you know, they are really stressed.
Mm-hmm.
So it's, no.
I worry about them. I do. I have to be honest.
Something I also didn't care for in his little opening thing when he was talking about being feminine or something during the dancing, my, like, claws came out a little bit. I was just like, I kind of shut out after that. I was just like, I don't know. I just don't like that. Whenever people automatically assume that just because you're dancing that you're feminine, I'm like, that's not what, I don't know. It just makes me uncomfortable.
I totally agree. Yeah. We get on that all the time. Yeah. Sir, what do you think of Keyshawn and Sharna?
Interesting couple. I did expect a little more from him just based on football players' past, but I do think it was nerves. Yeah. A little bit with him, and that we will, should he be around, you know, longer, we will see more from him.
Yeah. I have to be honest, I think he's going home next week.
I wouldn't be surprised.
He has the samba, so we'll see what happens. We'll see what the samba looks like.
Move those hips.
Can we just say that Sharna in those gold pants looked amazing?
Oh, I couldn't stop staring at her butt.
Looks really good.
She looked great. The whole cast looks actually pretty good.
They did. I wardrobe is always fantastic on that show, but Sharna's butt looked good. Thumbs up, Sharna. I love it. We give a shout out to Sharna's butt. And they got a 17. That's rough.
Yeah,
but it makes me worry because Bill Nye has enough of the, I think, America's vote.
Mm-hmm, the sympathy vote a little bit. Yeah.
We go to Christina and Mark. Christina Milian doing contemporary. This was my favorite contemporary of the night, even though she was a little bit, you know, into herself into herself in a shy way, not in an egotistical way. She definitely needs some confidence, but I'm kind of excited about this pairing.
She's going to really bust out, I think.
I think she's
too. I don't know. I've always had this special place in my heart for her from, like, her Disney days. I don't know why, but I just, like, I've always kind of kept up with her. So it makes me so excited to see her dancing. And I think she's going to be phenomenal. So I wish that she would really extend it out more, you know, and it connected with the audience a little bit, but I think that was just nerves, and that's just the first week out. I'm so excited to see what they're going to do.
She's like, dance for J-Lo.
Yeah.
How did it look in the studio? Because we did see her look down a little bit, like a little bit nervous.
I mean, I didn't notice that so much. I mean, sitting on the side, you see a different view, and the energy as well, it feels really different. So I thought Mark did a fantastic job with this piece.
I do too.
I loved the whole thing. I thought it was, from top to toe, it was amazing. And again, it's hard. Everyone's doing so good.
It is one of those weeks where you're just like, wow, what the heck is going on? But it is so good. And I thought that the contemporary was assembled probably the best out of the numbers.
And the music, the piece as well, I thought was stunning. The music he used as well, everything.
It was great.
I think we're going to have to watch out for her too. She could be in...
I can't wait to see her do some bottom stuff. Like, I feel like samba, she's going to nail.
Yeah. What does she have next week? Let me see if I have it. Let me see if I have the scoop. Paso.
Oh. I think she'll be good at that because she's a very strong and sturdy little girl. Yeah.
I think she can handle it. I was worried about her boobs popping out.
I'm sure that taped in there.
They were taped. Sorry. What did you think about this contemporary piece?
I think this is a very exciting couple to watch. It was a great routine. I think I'm going to love her future dances more, to be honest. But, you know, I'm a Mark fan. He always comes up with some great stuff. So I'm really excited about this couple.
Yeah, they got a 22. I thought maybe that was a little low. Yeah. I could have 23, 24.
Again, I thought 24.
The scores, were a little bit off.
If they were going to give Elizabeth the 24, I think that she should have gotten a 24.
Yeah, exactly.
I totally think that was a little uneven right there.
Yeah.
Now, this is someone that we're going next to. Another Bill. Bill Engvall, and with Emma, who got moved up from Troop. We're very excited for her, which her story is interesting because she was supposed to do Strictly Come Dancing as a pro, and all of a sudden, she's here in the U.S.
Shocking.
Shocking, yeah. I heard a little bit about the behind-the-scenes shenanigans, but glad we got her in the U.S., so there you go. So I didn't really know who Bill was, I have to be honest. Like, I don't really follow the redneck country comedy blue-collar tour or whatever it is.
Oh, my God.
But he's very surprising. Shocking. I'm not a fan of Jeff Foxworthy. He did the Jeff Foxworthy show for years. But he's pretty charming.
He is.
He's pretty charming.
And I was kind of impressed. I thought he was a really good leader, too. I think he led her really well. I mean, at least she made it seem like he led her really well, I think. But I thought he was really smooth. I expected him kind of be lumbering and kind of staccato-y and kind of all over the place. But I was pleasantly surprised. I don't think that he'll last long because, for me, he's not that memorable. Mm-hmm. But he did better than I expected.
I wrote, I expected him to suck. I really did.
Yeah.
Because comedians don't normally do well in this show.
Yeah.
I mean,
he had some finesse. He was real smooth. He was super calm, I thought. Really collected.
He looked in control. Yeah. He looked in quiet control. And, I mean, I just spoke to Emma before, and she said he was really unhappy with the marks and what the judges said. And, I mean, you know, I thought, again, a little bit harsh, but, you know, he did look fully in control of the dance and himself. Which, that's not easy to do, especially being, again, the male celebrity on the show.
That's tough.
It's not an easy job. And you got someone like Emma on your arm, and, you know, you got to step it up. So I thought he did pretty good for himself. I was surprised.
I know. I love being surprised.
I'm like, again.
Yeah, but there were some that I had expectations here and there. Yeah. A little disappointed. And then others I had expectations of, like, you're not going to be good. And he was. How did Emma feel about her big debut? I mean, that's exciting.
I mean, she was fully excited. She, I think she loved it. She loved it.
And she's dress.
I know.
Fantastic.
She looks so good. I'm so happy for her.
Yeah.
Yeah, too bad she's not pretty or anything.
I know.
Suri, what did you think of Bill? Were you surprised?
I actually agree 100% with everything Jake has said about this couple. You know, I didn't expect much. Anything, maybe. when I was watching, I was like, oh, okay, all right, this is interesting. He actually can move a little. This is you know, good.
Yeah.
So I was happy for Emma, of course, and. You know, we'll see. I don't think it's going to last very long, but you never know.
I think he's got to bring out some more character if he's going to try and stand a bit more.
But also, I mean, a lot of people in the Midwest, they do know who he is.
They do. Just because we're on the West Coast, can't ignore other states.
I'm in the Midwest. I'm going to ask people tomorrow how many people.
Do a survey for us while you're in Chicago.
Just
I love Chicago. Their Foxtrot got an 18, and then we move into, I don't even know if I'll get through this without, like, my mascara running down my face. Let's talk about Valerie Harper and Tristan doing the Foxtrot. And I have to read her quote because I think we should... I'm going to cry. I think we should all just remember it. She just said, it's good to be alive. It's even better to be dancing. Yeah. It's just a great philosophy. The first time I ever cry on Dancing with the Stars. But, I don't care where she winds up. I have to be honest.
Yeah.
This is such a great... thing to see, and it's inspiring to me because you have to live every day to its fullest, and I think that's what I want to say. I'm going to let you talk for a minute because
I know, me too. I'm like a little teary, but she just reminds me of my grandmothers who both passed away from cancer, and it's so nice to see someone out there who's willing to be like, I'm just going to have fun. I mean, and no telling how long we're going to have her in the scheme of life, basically, I'm so overwhelmed and overjoyed that she is on this show. Believe they got her in the first place. Like, that's amazing. And I think Tristan's the perfect partner for her.
And I get it. A lot of his fans, because he's another one with his fans, like, love him, and I know that they want him with a contestant that's maybe a little bit younger. I mean, she's 73, 74.
Mm-hmm.
But listen, what everyone's going to walk away with following the story, whether they get the Mirror Ball trophy or not, we're all just winners for watching the story unfold.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Was there a dry eye in the studio last night?
I mean, no, like, it was full on. That story especially, I was excited to see how that was going to come out and the performance of it as well. And I know Tristan definitely, you know, things happen for a reason, and there'll be a reason why they're together dancing, and he's such an awesome dude.
So great.
And, you know, I think it's a great little couple, actually. And
Me too.
He's going to... I think he's really going to help her, I think, you know, in this whole experience as well. He is the perfect one for her. I mean, it would, yeah, it's going to be good.
I think it's going to be magical.
And, yeah, you know, magical. Yeah, that's good.
Yeah, I think it's just a different story. I mean, she had a little trouble with her head spotting, but I don't care.
But she's, she actually can dance, too.
Yeah.
She's a trained Broadway dancer.
Yeah, exactly, and perform. And she, you know, you wouldn't even have a clue that she's been so sick. You wouldn't have had a flying clue.
She's taking a day off every week, too, because she has to do chemo, and she needs a day of rest. So they're going to have one less day of rehearsal than everyone else. So, you know what? Just think about that and think about how...
She was so excited. I remember the smile on her face, I think, the whole entire time, right?
It just, beaming the entire... I mean, like, anything. She was just,
loved
like,
it, which was so good
heaven.
To see.
Sorry, do I hear you crying from Chicago?
I know. Did you hear those tears?
I did.
I cried the entire performance. I mean, who wasn't? Tristan, first of all, an absolutely 100% perfect, classy partner for her.
Yes.
Well done, Dancing with the Stars, for pairing them up. I loved how he stepped away when they were finished with the routine and let her have that moment, even though she didn't really, wasn't wanting it herself.
But
it was just so beautiful. I have no words other than we have been given a great gift.
Yeah.
Yep. Mm-hmm. We're all going to learn a really good life lesson this season.
Yeah, for sure.
We
really are.
Their score was 21, which I thought was great. I can't wait to see more from them.
Yeah.
I hope they have something really fun.
What do they got next week? Actually, I don't know what they have.
I don't have theirs.
I hope it's the Jive or something kind of silly.
Oh my gosh, that'd be crazy.
Vibrant, yeah.
Yeah, I have, right, this is what I have so far. Keyshawn Samba, Bill Engvall Jive, Elizabeth Samba, Christina Paso, Corbin Jive, Brant Rumba, Jack Rumba, Bill Nye Paso. That's what I had so far.
Interesting.
And they got a 21 on Foxtrot. We move into Nicole Snickle, Snooky.
What are we calling her? She wants Nicole.
She wants Nicole.
She's a mom. She wants Nicole.
She's mom. And
she's no longer drunk all the time.
Like. I'm going to kind of miss sloppy Snooky. But she's with Sasha.
I'm so happy.
They've been great friends to the show, and we're so happy to see that their success. She's so petite. She is like a little pocket size. Okay, but she's not a pocket rocket, Len.
Well, hold up. What's wrong with that? I don't know what can you say? I
didn't. Pocket rocket?
A pocket rocket is a...
In New Zealand, Australia,
it's a female
English.
Sexual toy. It's a dildo. Can I say dildo? I just said it.
Really? It is?
Kids, if you're under 18, I didn't say
because
that.
Because Lynn said it, and I was like, yeah, a little pocket rocket, that's what I'll call it. And then everyone's like, no. And I'm like, what? And I turned to my friend. My friends from New Zealand were here as well, and they're like, what's wrong with pocket rocket? Like, we don't know.
It's like lost in translation.
That was awesome, though.
Yeah. I was just saying, it's a family show, and everyone's
she
like,
is tiny.
Oh, my God.
She is tiny.
She's tiny.
If he said that in England on Strictly, everyone would understand what it was. It's just because I think we're in America.
Yeah, she's 4'9".
4'9". Does that qualify you as a little person?
Believe it.
I think so. I think 4'10" does, but she's not, though.
Yeah, she's not.
Petite.
She's just small.
She's petite. This was a fun cha-cha. She has nicer lines than I thought. I was surprised.
Completely blown away by her. I expected her to come out there and be like, Mike, the situation, just like a hot damn mess. she just sold it. I thought she would hold back a lot because I thought maybe she'd be a little embarrassed doing this. But I was blown away by what she did. I thought she worked the camera and looked right in, and everyone in the audience she connected with. And that's what she got a standing ovation for a reason.
She was a performer.
I'm really excited. And they're such a cute little, like, nugget-sized couple. I love it. They're so cute.
I like them a lot. And Sasha's got enough fire that it matches well with Snooky, Snickle, whatever.
She's a big
Nicole.
Personality.
Jules, what was it like in the studio?
I think everyone was really, like, not nervous for her, but everyone was like, didn't know what to expect. I think we were all, and everyone was watching her, like, even like my friends from New Zealand were here, and they were like, oh, I can't wait to see Snooky dance. Like, this is amazing. Like, how did they get her? You know, it's like, this ridiculous. And I was real surprised as well. Like, and I thought Sasha did such a great job. Mm-hmm. And the whole package of it, of the choreography and how he did everything, and even the couple together matches so well.
So perfect.
So well. And
that reveal.
Yeah, that was hot. She did a great job. And I think, was it Len or someone said about her legs or her toes and like pointed?
Super
like,
toned and like...
I'm like, what is going on here?
Good.
So again, one to watch. And I have a feeling they may be hanging around.
I would be so happy if they did.
I hope they do.
I think so.
Yeah, because I mean, if you start looking at people in fan bases, and some people probably only see the old Snooky, but I like the new Nicole. Mm-hmm. And yeah. Suri, yeah. What did you think about the little pocket rocket?
You guys are killing me over here. you guys are all Snooki fans, obviously. I wasn't necessarily a big fan of hers going in. I didn't know what to expect. I didn't expect much, I can tell you that.
Yeah.
But some of her smaller movements really surprised me, and they were really nice.
Yeah.
So I think, and she is such a performer. I think that a little bit of dance or gymnastics, cheerleading or something background, Kristen, I think you mentioned that to me earlier, definitely shows. So I'm excited to watch it. It was a great way to finish the show, and we'll see what she brings to the table.
I can't wait.
I think there's heaps in there as well, and I think they really played it cool for first week. It was just enough. It wasn't too much, wasn't too less. I thought it was quite good. So
it is interesting, and they're rehearsing in New Jersey. They took off right after the show.
Sasha's gotta go. I'm like, what?
He doesn't even get to stick around and party, but they're rehearsing all week. I even asked Sasha, I was like, come in. He's like, we're in New Jersey this year, so we'll see what happens.
Crazy.
I know, so hopefully they'll stick around in LA 1 week and we'll grab let's get the Snook on the TV.
That'd be cool.
Here at AfterBuzz. Let's go to a couple fan questions for Jules, because we've got a lot of questions for you. This one's from Kina, who is the one that got you here. She's like, she bugged me all season. I was like, I got to get him on. So, and Jonathan, they both asked the same question. When you're pro, who would you want your celeb to be?
Oh, man. If I was pro, who would I want my celeb to be?
I can't believe you haven't been asked this question before.
My friend, everyone's been asked it, actually. And then I hear their answers. I'm like, okay. And then I never even thought, like, maybe someone did ask me, I said Paris Hilton.
Ooh.
I could see that.
And I think someone did ask me ages ago, and I think I said, actually, Paris Hilton, been a fan for a little while, I don't know.
She's a blonde. I mean, I could kind of see her coming on the show, too.
Yeah.
She's another one that's reinvented herself.
Lindsay Lohan,
there's been rumors a couple times that she's going to do a show.
Yeah, I heard that too.
I don't think she will, and this is my thought. She really wants to have a movie career, mm-hmm.
She should, too, because she's super talented.
And I just think Dancing with the Stars opens up a lot of, it seems to be hosting TV personality mm-hmm. opportunities and things like that, and I don't think that's the direction she wants to go in. It's just my thought. Cecile. All right, so let's see. To you, Julian. Or Jules, she has you down as Julian. What is your favorite moment as a troop member last season?
My favorite moment? There were so many. There's so many. I mean, performing at the first show was just like unreal. The energy in that ballroom before you go on, all the crowds clapping, it's like the best feeling in the world to have, actually. So every time before you go on, I love that feeling. I love the energy. Performing with Stevie Wonder, Michael Bublé. I mean, there's so many of my favorite singers that we got to dance with. It was fantastic.
Did you like the side number?
Sigh, that was so hilarious. Like, we were just like up there, like just having so much fun. It was ridiculous. I mean, it's hard to pinpoint just one.
There were a lot of good performers last season.
Yeah, last season the guests were amazing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I had such a great time. So, sorry, I can't pinpoint one, but... Yeah.
You had lots of good moments.
I had lots.
Now, I know you're not on full time with the troupe this season, but are you going to be coming back?
Yeah, I'm going to be coming back later on. I think as they're still working the format out right now, like as they slowly get rid of the slabs and stuff and kick people out, we'll be doing more pro performances, I think.
Okay, great.
So later on, I heard that later on there'll be stuff going on. So, yeah.
Maybe
so
like the double partner.
Yeah, all this stuff going on. So we'll see what's in store. Just working all out still.
That's good. What are you doing in the meantime? Because I know you've been traveling all over the place.
Yeah,
you were in Singapore and Australia and
through the summer I've been teaching in Singapore and had a couple of shows in Hong Kong and Japan, and I just got back literally on Sunday from Singapore, and I was in Australia as well teaching over there. So I'm back and forth a little bit, and got a couple of gigs going on here and stuff. So
keeping
me busy. That's actually crazy. The second half of the year is like
good.
Quite crazy.
No, I was actually, I had insomnia one night, and this is how he's in Singapore at normal hour, and I'm like, 2 or 3 a.m., I'm like, I can't sleep, so I'm going to email you.
Thank God for insomnia.
Insomnia, got you here. From Sasha Katz, she wants to know, what's your favorite moment you've had on Dancing with the Stars? Do you have your first week out? Everyone has similar questions in terms of, they all like to know what your favorite moment mm-hmm. was, what stands out. And Kina, she's so funny. But what do you like to do in your off time when you're not working, what's your favorite thing to do?
I like to keep busy. I mean, but just like chill out by like the pool or go to the beach, and like I brought my surfboard over and I'm getting ready to take that back out. It's been a little while, so I'm really looking forward to that. Just chilling in the sun. I love the sun. That's why I love LA. I love being here. So I was in London for like 6 years, and it was like cold, oh my God. Dark. It was a long 6 years of my life. Yeah,
now, have you performed on Strictly Come Dancing and Dance with the Stars Australia? I mean, how does that work?
Yeah, I mean, actually, that's how I got this gig. They asked me to cast for Strictly over there, and I said, I really want to do the American show. And they're like, really? And I'm like, I want to do this one. And so they're like, okay. So they set up the meetings with me here, over here. So wow. I performed on a couple of other shows, cable sort of shows in England and in Australia. And actually, Emma and I met on the West End in England. So we've known each other for a long time, Emma and I. So that's cool. It's cool. And we toured around Europe together, dancing and stuff. And then we both ended up here. It was really cool.
That's cool.
You know, we've heard a lot that it's hard to move from like Dancing with the Stars Australia to Dancing with the Stars US or Strictly Come Dancing. Like they're their own separate shows. It's hard to be
yet
like
they're connected all up with BBC. So it's interesting. It's all
connected, but at the same time they're all separate. So it's not easy to be like, oh, I'm going to do one season of this and one season of that and be over here. They really want to keep you.
Yeah, like I know, like Kim. Again, you have to get permission to do it. You know, so it's not easy. It's not easy to do that. And I think she's really lucky to be able to do that. It's really cool for her too.
Yeah, then she's gonna be a judge, so a different side, different perspective.
And she started on that show as the pro, and now she's come here and she's done so well, and then they've asked her to do that. I mean, it's pretty cool.
I hope we get to see some of the YouTube video of that, because I would like to see and hear her perspective, because when you have both sides of it, you understand what everyone's going through, but she also has the experience of what to look for, which I think is good.
Yeah.
Fantastic. Definitely. All right, well, I think we should get into predictions of what's going to happen, who's going to be eliminated. All right, so...
And now, you're after Buzz TV.
Predictions. Oh. I know, I love the sound effects. So, I want everyone to tell me who, not who you think's going to win, it's too early out to say who's going to win, but who you think's going to get voted off next week, and who is your person to look out for this season? Jake.
My person to look out for this season is Amber Riley. I love her. And I think who's going to be voted off is Keyshawn. I'm sorry. I'm just not, nothing, no offense to him. I'm just not responding to it.
It's okay. It's okay, Jake.
I'm sorry.
I still love you. No. Go ahead.
To look out for, this is a tough one again. Mm-hmm. I mean, I really hope our little pocket rocket pulls some things out later on.
I don't
to be serious. Yeah. Snooki Nicole. definitely watch out for her, I think. Going home, I mean, I don't know Bill, the science guy, but I mean, I wasn't so impressed with him. But again, his fan base is huge.
Huge.
So I'm not sure. Actually.
We'll find out in week two, won't we? Yeah. Sorry. What do you think?
I think, you know, Sharna and Keyshawn could be in danger, potentially Leah and Tony. And then one to look out for, I'm torn between Val and Elizabeth and Christine and Million and Mark.
Mm-hmm. All right. I'm going to say it's Keyshawn going home next week. And I think that Christina is one to watch. I think that she's going to make some big strides. For sure. And I think Mark is the right person to get her there. I think he's going to push her in the right direction. All right, you guys, we're going to be back next week. I don't know who our guest is yet, but we're going to find out. We're going to find out. I'll be up at 2 or 3 hours in the morning. Who knows? Whatever. Jake, where can we find you?
You can find me on Twitter at Jake_Dupree and on Instagram at Jake Dupree.
Suri, where can we find you?
Instagram, Twitter, Facebook at Suri Serrano.
And our guest, Jules, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much for having me.
Where can we find you?
You can find me on Twitter at Jules Talker and Instagram at Jules Talker as well.
All right, and I'm Kristen Burt at Kristen Burt on Twitter and redcarpetcloset.tv. Thanks so much for joining us. We will see you next week.
From Bing.com, executive producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV network. To watch or listen to other after shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
Buzz you later.
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.